Hey, this is Victor. Hope you're doing well. Okay, so in today's video, I wanted to talk to you about your website's hero section. So your website's hero section is the very first thing you see when you come to a website. It's the big, typically it's an image above the fold on the home page of your site. And most people don't really understand like what the purpose of this is for. You know, like what are some things that you should think about when you're setting up your hero section and kind of like how to think of your hero as like the main advertisement or the main first thing that people see. It's if you know, like there's an 80-20 rule with everything. Well, your website's hero section is definitely like one of those things where like you should really spend an inordinate amount of time thinking about your hero section rather than kind of all the other elements of your site, because that's going to be like the very first thing that most people see when they come to your site. So I'll share with you some of the best practices, some of the things that we do when putting together hero sections for your site. So let's watch. Okay, so let's take a look at some hero sections and just let me give you kind of my thoughts on things that you might want to think about when putting together a hero section and kind of best practices and that type of thing. So the very first thing you should think about when just like putting together your hero section is understanding like this is like the headline for your website. You know, one thing I study a lot of is direct response advertising. And so that's people who like used to send stuff in the mail and now they do it through you know, internet marketing. But they would you know, sell stuff, and if they didn't sell it that one time, like that was their big chance. And so they would spend an inordinate amount of time thinking about the headline of their piece, and like they would split test that and work on that forever. And so kind of your hero section is like that headline. Like if you thought of it as a sales letter, that's the main thing. And the main purpose of the headline when it came to direct response is just to get people to keep reading, right? You can't buy something if you don't keep reading the letter. So the very first thing was just to get people to stay there. So, you know, one thing that most people see when they get to their website is when they get to their Google Analytics on their website, I should say, is that they see their bounce rate. And their bounce rate is how many people like come to a site and then just hit the back button and then don't do anything else, right? And so and it's huge. Typically, you know, with people, there's like something like 80% of most websites, they stay for less than 10 seconds. Sometimes it's as much as 90% for most of the clients that I see. And so your headline, your hero section here is your big opportunity to kind of change that and not have people kind of bounce out without seeing you. So let me give you some thoughts in terms of like what I do with my clients for kind of making engagement and you know, engaging and active, like they with strong calls to action where they want people like take action on the site, that kind of thing. So here's my own site here. And so, you know, our thing is, you know, there's two ways to think about it. Number one, there's like what's the message, right? And of all the things you can think about, I would say this is the most important thing, is you want a clear, strong message to have people take a next action or at least be curious, right? So in this particular one, I'm saying I have a free custom mock-up. Anyone who comes to the site, you know, they're looking for a website. Hopefully that's something that would be interesting them and intrigue them and want to kind of have them take that next step, right? So the very first thing is, what's the thing that you're saying? And it should definitely relate to like the needs of the people who are coming to the site, right? So you gotta think about, you know, one of my favorite marketing sayings is, you know, people don't want to buy drills, they want to buy quarter inch holes. They want the result. They don't care about you. They don't care how long you've been in business. They don't care about, you know, even your reviews on Yelp, only to the degree that it builds credibility. But what they care about is the problem they have and the result they want. And so your headline, your main offer, has to be something that makes it clear and easy to understand that you do the thing that they're looking for. They don't want to be confused. When they come to the site, they want to know, okay, this person does the thing I'm looking for. And then if there's a compelling offer, there's something you can give them for that, even better. But at least make it clear. A lot of people get caught up in being too cute, too fancy, or whatever, and like that's just like the wrong way to do it. And then you have like your actual hero image right behind you, the thing that you do it. And so typically there's a few things you can do. So you can either have a video like I have here. You can do a slider where you have like a slider sliding through here. Or you can just have like a good old static image. So if you go to like stripe.com, this is just a static hero section. There's no slider, there's no video, and you know, the kind of there's benefits to all of them. So let me explain like why people do kind of each one of those and what, you know, what the reasoning would be and why you might want to do one for like your particular site, like what would be best for you. Okay, so With the video, I like video. What's cool about a video is you can tell a story. So like in this example here, I'm doing a free mock-up, and then this is a video of a guy, you know, drawing a mock-up, and then there's a person coding a website. And then the third video is someone receiving the mock-up, where they're looking at the finished product, right? And so it's kind of telling the story and tying into this, you know, free custom mock-up. Here's another company. This is called Infinity Fuel. We did them, and they do like batteries that work in outer space and underwater. And we happen to find this amazing video on iStock Photo where it shows, like, starts off in outer space, it goes all the way into underwater, and it says power at any altitude. So they provide battery, fuel cell storage in underwater and in outer space. So it just kind of works out well that this is kind of telling that particular story, right? Here's another one, Zappatini, where, you know, they're a family office. They own a lot of commercial real estate in San Francisco. And this is a very cool kind of over, I don't know if it's a drone, but it's a stock video of above the sky in San Francisco. And that, you know, number one, it looks really cool. And that's a perfectly good reason to have a hero video, as long as it's engaging and ideally relevant to the thing that you're trying to say. So one is a video. Challenges with videos is sometimes they run a little slow. It'll make your site load slower. So we did a different video on like how to load a hero video fast every time. And so be sure and watch that video because it's totally relevant and it'll help solve that problem. But that's the idea with a video. It's cool. It's engaging. For right now, it's like, you know, still kind of new. Not everyone has one. So it's kind of fun. People like them. So that's, you know, there's some novelty aspect to it. So that's one idea. Another one is just the good old static. This is what you're going to see. And so, you know, obviously with Stripe and a lot of, you know, kind of these other big companies, they just have one thing. This is the first thing you see, and that's kind of all you're going to see. And you're really directing people's attention. You know, when people come to the site, you have to think about, like, what's the visual hierarchy? What's the first thing they're going to see? What's the second thing they're going to see? And what's, you know, kind of what's, how's that going to go down? And you want to kind of think about that when you're putting together your hero section. You want to make it clear and easy. And so sometimes you just want a static, you know, kind of no nonsense. We did that here where, you know, kind of this is the only thing they're seeing and that's it. Now, this is a good example of kind of what not to do as well. So there's two things that, looking back at this, kind of are problems. And these are big problems that typically show up in hero sections. So one of them is when you have text over a busy image background like you see here, right? It makes the text very, very hard to read. And so, like, I would not recommend using this image again for this text. The only other way around it is to make the text really, really big, which I'll show you an example of in a second. And then the other thing is just think about how your hero section will look across multiple widths. So for example, this is what it looks like on a regular desktop, but on widescreen, it doesn't quite look as good. And this is kind of a little bit proportionally, a little bit off to the right. I was looking, where is it here? Yeah, so this is like my wife's website. And so one thing is like, it looks, again, this is just a static image, right? And this is kind of telling a story, a clean statement of purpose, that's it. And then it looks kind of much better here on regular, but when you look at it on widescreen, it kind of goes over the baby's face a little bit, and that's not as good. What you really want to do is, whether it's a video, whether it's a static image, you want the text to be either in some kind of negative space so that you can read it, or you want to have some kind of background, you know, behind the text. Or what we do a lot is do some kind of an overlay. So for example, going back here to the Zappatini site, like this site here, there's an overlay overlaying the text. It's like some kind of a dark filter that then makes it hard to see. Yeah, I'm probably not gonna be able to find this right here, but I assure you, there's an overlay that makes all of this darker. And so that's kind of one of the challenges that people have is, you know, they want to have like a bright image, but then you have to kind of overlay that thing to make the text visible. So that's another thing to think about. Other things to think about as well. Oh, so let's finish with the slider. Okay, so why would you have a slider? So one of the biggest challenges with a lot of websites in general is that, you know, there's a person
you know, the way I think about a website, like there's a person, they're looking for something, there's a next step they want to take. And my job is to help identify, you know, who are those different types of people? What is it that they're looking for? And so, you know, in a nonprofit, for example, you know, there's different people. There are people looking for different things. So in this particular one, they have camperships, they have scholarships, they want to share about, like, you know, the history, people who are interested in going. And then they might have like specific announcements, like things that they want to share that are topical. And so that's a reason to have a slider. Or another reason might be, you know, they have different areas of expertise or specialties where they want people to kind of pay attention to it. This is a good example of like bad contrast here. You can't see the text that there's actually, it looks better here, right, on regular screen. But then when you go to widescreen, then all of a sudden this half of the text here becomes invisible. So that's always something to think about. Yeah, this is a good example of the overlay. So here's, you know, kind of, there's a video, it's kind of sharing about small businesses, and then there is a text, but the only way you can read it is with this overlay. If it wasn't there, you wouldn't be able to read it. Okay, so that's that. Other things to think about are buttons. Like, so do you want one button, two buttons, no buttons? There's no right answer, but you always want to make it as like call to actionable as possible, right? And so in my example, there's people, the way I think about it, some people just want to read. So when you click learn more, it's just going to go to start reading, versus some people, you know, like want to watch a video. So in this particular instance, it goes to a pop-up video that tells more about that thing, which I think is fine. I think where it gets a little problematic is we have two separate call to actions that are different. But sometimes you have to, like, for example, here on the Tracker Corp, like the problem with them is they have like two major brands that are different. They have the I-9 brand and the immigration brand, and they really want to make it clear that you can do either. So in this particular example, they really do need to have these two buttons here, because otherwise, you know, people, when they come here, the very first thing they want to know is they already know about the company, they already know about the brand, and they're just trying to find the right place. And so this is where they would need to go. This is also another example. Some people kind of get freaked out with this hero section and they want it to be like as short as possible so they can kind of shove more stuff in here underneath. And like, that's not always the way I would do it. The way I like to think about it is I like to have one thing at a time. I think most people know how to scroll these days. So this notion that everything has to be above the fold is kind of no longer as relevant or as useful anymore. So that's some thoughts there. Let me see some thoughts. Okay, so yeah, this was another example. So where you see like the text is hard to read over this image. Now, if you look here at what we did initially, we had the text really, really big here. So it was, you know, you could actually see it and it makes sense. But when you have it like this and you have like much smaller text, then it's gonna be much harder to read. Other things you could do, you could have like an actual form above the fold. That's definitely something that people can do. Again, you want to make sure that you're able to focus on, this is the first thing I want to read, learn more. There's an arrow pointing here, and then it's going to a form. Again, this is a good use of negative space. So you're using an image, but it's got big text here. It's got a negative space here with the background. It's just kind of neutral. And you're seeing this first, then the Golden Gate Bridge. It all kind of makes sense, right? Let's see here. Yeah, this is another example of a slider where they have like, you know, different use cases that they want to highlight here. And so this is where you would kind of want that slider. And again, there's like news and information directly above the fold as well. That's something to consider. So the other thing I wanted to do is I just thought those were all like my sites. I just randomly Googled Dentist Oklahoma for the purpose of just kind of doing some random reviews and seeing if I could kind of give quick critiques on things people are doing, just to give you some ideas of like what works, what doesn't work for a hero section. So I don't know any of these people, and please take no offense. So so this site here, you know, it has the video. I would like it better if they had some kind of headline. I feel like this logo section is taking away from everything. And yes, it's kind of trying to tell you something, but the watch with sound is a little bit not too clear, and it just feels a little busy. Like, I really don't know what I'm supposed to be looking at, and so I feel a little bit disjointed, like looking at this video. This one here was interesting. It says, you know, a different dental experience. It has the overlay so you can read the text better. It does have a call to action to the video, but the video in the background is telling the story. And it seems to me like there's a, it's all about personalization. It looks like these people care. Everything here is all about, you know, kind of the experience and that there is engagement here. And so I think this works. I would say yes to this hero video. This is another good clear call to action. You have people smiling. You have, you know, the name of the company here. I'm sure they're trying to do some SEO here with the Northwest OKC. And you have the call to action of make an appointment with a button or a phone call. Yelp reviews, like this all looks like very good kind of marketing driven stuff here. Whereas this one here, this looks okay. It's not ugly. But it has the text in the negative space, but it doesn't have a strong call to action. It's not nearly as it's not going to drive nearly as many conversions as that other one I just showed. So, and it just kind of has like, you can do this if you want. But where the other one is like, call us right now and here's why you should do that. So I like that better. This one here, kind of going to that first image, I have read studies that people looking away are less engaging than people looking at you. And so when you're doing your hero image, you probably want to have people looking at you, looking at the user rather than looking away, because I've heard that that is, or at least read in books via studies, that that is not as engaging. Again, here it's a little hard to read, and it doesn't really explain like what that first video image did to here, and now we're going to something else. A little disjointed. Probably don't love it. Okay, so this one here is like bad, right? And so the reason it's so bad is like my brain, my eyes don't even know like where to look here. So am I supposed to be looking at this first or this first? There's way too much room for this header, and then the hero section is kind of smushed down. We have this kind of weird green color with the overlay. This text here is too hard to read. My brain is looking at this and kind of couldn't read this if it wanted to. And then there's like three calls to action. So bad, right? Not a good hero section. This one too, not that great. You know, it has all this text here, way too much text. Like you want a sentence, like a you know, like 4 or 5 word sentence tops to be your hero headline, and that's it. Like no one's gonna read this. And then there's no call to action. And everything's kind of busy, so I would say no to like this particular hero section. And this looks like the same one that we just saw. I think it's just a different company. Maybe they're an internet marketing company, but again, good stuff. People are smiling, looking, has the headline, make an appointment, call to action. That would work for me. So those are some thoughts I have about the hero section. Again, remember, it's like the very first thing that people see when most people come to your site. It's definitely worth working on and thinking about. And the main things are is like make it clear, make it engaging, make it a call to action. And then think about the visual hierarchy. Think about like what's the first thing people are going to see? What's the second thing? What's the call to action? What's the contrast? Where's the text going to go? That type of thing. So hopefully you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like. Feel free to subscribe to the channel. If you need help with your website project, we offer a free mock-up of your website before you sign or pay for anything. So visit Thomas Digital to learn more. Thanks again, and I will see you in the next one.